Here's a word coming in from Arun Jaitley, attacking the current state of alliance in Karnataka. He says that the Karnataka situation is an obvious consequence of non-ideological, opportunistic alliance with no positive agenda. The basis of the negative agenda is keep Modi out. These ideologically flexible political groups have an extremely dubious track record of governance. To rule a large country like India through coalitions is possible, but the nucleus of a coalition has to be stable. A federal front is a failed idea. It was experimented under Sri Charan Singh, Sri Chandrasekhar, and by the United Front government during 1996 to 98, but failed to deliver. This view that Arun Jaitley has sent out as far as the Karnataka state government alliance here is concerned, coming in following days of reports indicating that there is already a crack in the alliance. We have with us our deputy news editor Meenakshi Bhanja, getting us further inputs here on all that has been stated by Arun Jaitley on this. Meenakshi, please go ahead.
Well, absolutely, Seher. This is Arun Jaitley's point of view, and he is extrapolating on this to really draw on his inference for the alliances that are likely to be stitched for 2019. Abhyus will recall there is a lot of talk of a lot of political parties getting together, especially the non-BJP political parties. For instance, Chandrababu Naidu, one-time friend and now turned foe of the BJP, who has been at the helm stitching these alliances together. Abhyus will recall he was also present at the swearing-in of H.D. Kumaraswamy. And Arun Jaitley making the point as to how if this Karnataka is a preview of what the Congress and the Federal Front promise for future. That is the larger point that he is making. And you correctly referred to as to how he is already assailing all the cracks that are emerging, the fissures that are emerging. It is also a clear indication of how the BJP hasn't forgotten what happened in Karnataka. Remember, they had bagged 104 assembly seats, but they were not able to gather the numbers which saw Yediyurappa really lose the vote of confidence in the Karnataka Assembly. And that is something which has not gone away yet for the BJP. And Arun Jaitley coming in and lashing out at all the displays of discomfiture that we have seen in JDS combined.
Absolutely. And as you say, this has been a display of discomfort publicly, while this is following a day of Kumaraswamy's emotional outburst just yesterday. They're saying that he's not comfortable. He feels pained by leading this alliance. You had Siddaramaiah earlier saying that he's doubtful that the alliance would run its course of full 5 years. So Arun Jaitley, at the end of the day, writing this statement only based on what the JDS and Congress leaders have been doing there in Karnataka, have openly been expressing that doubt themselves.
Well, absolutely, sir. And in one part of the statement, he goes on to say, Mr. Arun Jaitley, as to how, listening to these statements of the Honorable Chief Minister of Karnataka, my memory took me back to the tragedy era of Hindi cinema. If this is the consequence of a two-party coalition, what is it that a disparate group of parties with no ideological similarity offer to India, unquote. So clearly he's drawing upon this to extrapolate on a larger forum for 2019. He is also using this as a case study to indicate to the citizens as to how perhaps frugal or rather untenable this alliance of other political parties could be going ahead into 2019, given the fact that we have seen a lot of momentum being built by non-BJP parties to come together to form a larger alliance ahead of 2019. So here is Arun Jaitley assailing with the Karnataka example the proposals or the propositions that the opposition parties are in the midst of for stitching a larger alliance for 2019.